I played in Cincinnati with Juan Castro, and he was, we got to be pretty close and good friends, and still are, and still text to this day. He's someone that jumps to mind right away when you ask that as a player. And then Victor Martinez, I got to be pretty close with when I played with him in Cleveland. Those are two guys that just jumped in my mind when you asked. There's been many, of course. You know, obviously here, many, you know, from Seve to Gary Sanchez. I remember when Edwin Encarnacion came to our team, and he was really impactful in our room and had a lot of influence. Those are just a few names that people that I feel like impacted my career, whether it be as a player, friendships, or as a manager.
Bueno, Juan Castro es una persona que me viene a la mente inmediatamente, alguien con quien transcurso del año se convirtió en un buen amigo, que todavía tenemos una conversación muy cercana. Víctor Martínez, con quien pude jugar. Y si tú pones a pensar como dirigente, o sea, tú tendríamos que hablar de Luis Severino, Gary Sánchez, Edwin Encarnación, que aunque estuvo aquí no por mucho tiempo, pero sí tuvo un impacto muy profundo en nuestro camerino, en nuestro clubhouse. Definitivamente son personas a las que, tú sabes, de una manera u otra, son relaciones impactantes. And the second part of the question is, you know, being a young old manager, if you may, analytics, you know, strategies for the game, how do you balance it all?
You just do. I mean, that's every day. There's so much information available. You make it part of your process, what you want to take in, what you want to, you know, going into a series with a particular team, so playing St. Louis right now, the information available, trying to absorb all that, specific things you want to see, and then when I walk out to the dugout, now it's just play. You know, it's now we play. Like, we've prepared, we're ready, now we go out in the dugout, and it's compete. And so there's a lot of information. It's helpful. We use it to prepare every day, but when once 7 o'clock rolls around, now we go play the game.
Daniel?
Hold on. Jay.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Sorry.
Bueno, la respuesta es que hay que hacerlo, hay que balancear todo el tipo de información que te llega. La información es parte del proceso, tú la usas en una manera en la que te pueda ayudar a tomar las mejores decisiones posibles. Hay muchísima información, entonces tienes que entender que, en el día en sí, qué te va a ayudar y qué tal vez no te puede ayudar en ese día. Todo tiene que ver con el equipo al que te está enfrentando en ese momento. Entiendo de que es una ayuda, pero ya cuando llegan las 7 de la noche y es tiempo de cantar play ball, hay que jugar el juego en sí, de que te sientas, de que todo lo que hiciste hasta ese punto te ayudó a prepararte para ese momento, para tomar las mejores decisiones posibles, siempre y cuando tú estés ya enfocado en el juego y ya se convierta en algo automático para ti.
I was struggling in the series. I hadn't had any success against Tim Wakefield. And as I was walking up to home plate, I was going to take the first pitch. And as I got up to home plate, I kind of said, you're overthinking this. Just get a good pitch to hit. If that's the first pitch, if that's the third pitch, if it's the seventh, get a good pitch to hit. And it happened to be the first pitch, and then the rest is history.
Y para resumir, o sea, la pregunta es acerca de ese famoso turno de Aaron Boone en la serie de campeonato del 2003, en el 11 inning. Boone menciona que no había tenido éxito contra Tim Wakefield, enfrentando a Tim Wakefield, que era el pitcher de momento. No le había ido bien en esa serie. Estaba pensando en tomar un picheo, pero casi entrando a la caja de bateo, decidió buscar un buen picheo para conectar, aunque sea el primero, el segundo, el tercero, pero un buen picheo para conectar. Y ya entra en la caja de bateo, se dio el momento en el que él entendió que ese era el picheo y hizo swing y conectó.
Y esa es mi historia.
Sí.
Francis back middle. Aaron, given the fact that Luis Hill is coming off an injury, is he on a pitch count or an innings count? And if that's,
So he's going to throw in a rehab game Sunday?
Yes.
Yeah. He's throwing a rehab game Sunday, which I'm guessing will be 70, 80 pitches or so. So when he comes back, maybe somewhat of a pitch count, but he hasn't been out long. He's been able to continue to throw. So, it won't be too much less than what he normally has. As far as innings, no, we're just monitoring him and how he's feeling physically and trying to get measurements of where he's measuring at physically. As long as that's good, we're going to continue to go with him.
La pregunta tiene que ver acerca de Luis Gil regresando de la lesión, entendiendo si va a haber un límite de picheo o inning. Boo menciona que Gil va a hacer una salida de rehabilitación el domingo. Lo más probable serán algunos 70, 80 picheos en esa salida el domingo. No vemos que imponerle un límite de innings, pero sí monitorear la cantidad de lanzamientos que vaya haciendo, entender cómo se recupera físicamente, pero no entendemos que él tenga una cantidad límite de innings ya cuando regrese.
Time for a couple more.
For being here with us, spending some time with us. For you as the manager in the American League, you have the best record in the league. But what has been the most challenging part of the whole season, and how to push those guys in order to achieve the record, the goal, which is to get into the playoffs.
There's challenges at different times every season. Sometimes they're everything to do with baseball and between the lines. Sometimes it's, because we are like a big family, so it's 26 with guys on the injured list, 30 plus players and coaches and support staff. There's other things that come up all the time that are can be challenging throughout the year. You want to say that?
Bueno, siempre hay muchos obstáculos, especialmente en una temporada de Grandes Ligas que es tan larga. Tú tienes muchísimos obstáculos dentro del terreno, pero también fuera del terreno. Tú tienes un grupo de personas que no solamente son los jugadores, pero los coaches, los miembros del staff del equipo. Entonces, eso es la vida, es parte de la vida, enfrentarte a diferentes obstáculos.
The thing I would say is I try to create an environment, we try to create an environment that players want to come in, compete, prepare, and then go out and compete. And you want to create and foster that kind of culture throughout the year, because in 162 games and beyond, you're going to go through tough moments, tough times. So it's important that we set the tone each and every day with a will to prepare and a will to go out and compete. And that kind of mindset, I think, helps us get through the highs and the lows that are inevitable in the season.
Bueno, y entendiendo de que todo eso es parte de lo que tú vas a enfrentar en una temporada larga como esta,
Lo que yo quiero es crear un ambiente en el que los muchachos puedan prepararse para competir y poder tener una repetición día a día, crear un ambiente en el que se sientan cómodos, en el que puedan encontrar todo lo que necesiten para prepararse, para jugar un juego difícil y encontrar la manera de repetir eso cada día, independientemente de todos los momentos difíciles que vas a tener durante lo largo de la temporada. Y entendiendo que toda temporada tiene su alta y su baja y hay que buscar la manera de poder salir adelante durante una larga temporada.
Carlos.
Players missing, but two-part questions. First one, how do you handle pressure? What do you do to deal with pressure? And the second part question, how do you feel when you lose a big piece, an important piece of your lineup, a player that goes down, and it's somewhat of a difficult injury?
How do I deal with pressure? I try to maintain perspective all the time. It's hard some days, but I try that no matter what we're going through, we're flying high or you're going just through a really gut-wrenching, tough stretch, I try to have the perspective of it's a game. We're playing a game. And try to make sure we have fun doing that, but understand that it's a game. We all have people in our lives that are dealing with illness, maybe loss of a family member, loss of a loved one. There's so many more things out there that are more important than what we do between the lines. It's obviously very important to us, our livelihood. This is what we do and what we pour our lives into. But I try and always keep that perspective, especially when you're going through a real high moment or when you're at a low in the season. Try and keep that perspective that this is a game.
Bueno, una de las maneras que trato de manejar lo que es la presión es entendiendo de tener una perspectiva clara de que al final del día es un juego, ¿verdad? Hay momentos muy buenos, hay momentos malos, y creo que mantener una perspectiva en la que tú entiendas de que es un juego, de que fuera de aquí hay una vida real, todos tenemos vidas personales, familiares, que hay personas que pueda que estén pasando por momentos mucho más difíciles, que sería irse de cero en un juego de pelota, tal vez lidiando con una enfermedad. Entonces, claro, nos importa mucho, esto es nuestro trabajo, respetamos mucho lo que hacemos aquí, pero al final del día también entender, ¿verdad?, de mantener una perspectiva clara, pautada, entender de que al final del día es un juego que queremos mucho, pero que también tenemos que verlo como que, aunque tengamos toda esa responsabilidad con el deporte en sí, tenemos que entender que también hay una vida fuera de aquí. How do you deal with big injuries, you know?
You know that's part of the game. And when you go into a season, you know, hopefully you don't get decimated by them or have so many, but you know they're coming and you've got to be able to handle those things. So you try and support players the best you can, but also try and create an environment too where guys that you know are going to come in and have to replace guys that go down. Have a chance to be at their very best, hopefully because of the environment that we create.
Sí, bueno, las lesiones son parte del juego. Son cosas con las que tenemos que manejar durante una temporada larga. Sabes que van a pasar. Una de las cosas en las que nosotros nos enfocamos es apoyar a los jugadores cuando pasan por esas lesiones, porque son momentos difíciles, situaciones en las que tú son muchas cosas difíciles en las que los jugadores personalmente pueden pasar. Entonces tú es muy importante que, en crear un ambiente de apoyo para esos jugadores, a la misma vez crear un ambiente positivo para los jugadores que llegan a reemplazar esos jugadores para que se sientan cómodos, para que puedan ejecutar, para que puedan producir lo mejor que puedan, enfocado, claro, en ayudar al equipo.
We're going to take one more question with Moises. Hablo con Juan Soto sobre su futuro en los Yankees. Si algo que se pueda saber que tú le has recomendado o él te ha dicho. Y también sobre Jason Domínguez. Háblanos tu impresión sobre él. Si lo espera este año en Grandes Ligas, que venga en el último mes. Y todo lo bueno que pueda decirnos sobre ese dominicano, sobre ese pelotero latino. Gracias.
Sobre Domínguez.
Sobre Jason Domínguez.
Yeah, thank you for being here with us again. You know, a lot of talk about Juan Soto, but you know, understanding his future, have you had any chance, any conversation with him, or has he expressed, you know, liking playing here? What do you foresee? What can you tell us about his future? And Jason Dominguez also, what has impressed you about his abilities, and do you expect him in the near future?
I have no idea on Juan. With that being said, I've loved getting to manage him. He's like, I mean, he's a really good person, very easy for me to get to know and talk. But we haven't talked a lot about that. I mean, our focus is kind of on this team and what we need to do to try and go out there and win every day. And I've loved getting to do it with him and getting to know him. But we haven't got into that. That's for another day. And, you know, he's going to end up where he's supposed to. But I would like to think that he's really enjoyed this.
No.
Player and a person. Jason is smart, competitive, really talented. I think he's going to be a great player in this league. And I think there's a chance you'll see him. You know, he's obviously started the year injured, came back from that really well from Tommy John, and was playing really well, then got hurt again, missed some time, and I feel like he's starting to play well again here these last couple of weeks. But he's got a bright, bright future. He's going to be a really good player in this league for a long time, and you never know when it may be. It started from day one in spring training. He is just a really impressive person, first and foremost. Marlo?
Sí, definitivamente empezó desde el primer día. El primer día de spring training, el impacto que él ha tenido, solamente en el equipo, pero personalmente.
He's very easy to be around, but he's also very serious about his craft, about the game of baseball. And we saw that right away in spring training, how much he cares about, of course, his hitting, which gets a lot of attention, but also the other things in the game that he wants to be really good at, in the weight room, defense, running the bases. It all matters to him, and you see this is a great player, yes, but a winning player.
Y él tiene una cualidad, o sea, su personalidad, una personalidad totalmente muy amigable, fácil de tratar, a la misma vez muy serio en su trabajo, tiene una rutina de trabajo impecable. Entonces, todo eso lo hace, lo combina para ser una gran persona, un gran jugador, y eso hace que se acomode fácil, se acomodó fácil al equipo, y su personalidad es impresionante.
And to see the community and the fan base embrace him right away and him them back, that's been something to fun to witness.
Y también poder notar lo rápido que la comunidad lo ha acogido, la interacción de él con los fanáticos durante el juego, todo ha sido
muy bonito de ver y emocionante a la misma vez.